Thank you. as a result of the combined efforts of the various UAE tourism authorities. The tourism industry in the UAE saw many big achievements in 2013. According to the International Economic Forum, the UAE moved up from 30th worldwide in 2011 to 28th in the world last year. They also scored first in the Middle East and North Africa on the list of most advanced and developed countries in tourism and aviation. UAE tourism and travel earned 182.6 billion Emirati dirham by the end of 2012. The UAE also excelled in six other areas. They ranked number one in the world in strategic consistency for the tourism and travel industries. The UAE was also rated number three for environmental and sustainability upkeep and controls. The UAE ranked as best country in terms of developing the tourism sector in the Middle East and North Africa. As a result, the UAE has successfully attracted the lion's share of both leisure and corporate market segments in the region, while continuously maintaining the highest possible standards within the various hospitality sectors. The report commended the UAE for the outstanding marketing and promotion achievements of the tourism industry in general, ranking the UAE as number one worldwide in this category. Ladies and gentlemen, in random order, the best of the UAE tourism authorities. Ras Al Khaimah welcomed 1.24 million visitors in 2013, which is up from 1.1 million in 2012. Last year saw the opening of the iconic Waldorf Astoria Hotel, three new properties, the Rixus, Marjan Island DoubleTree by Hilton, and Marjan Island Resort and Spa are completed and open for business in 2014. Adding approximately 1,500 keys to the destination and announcing Marjan Island as a major new tourist hotspot. Cove Rotana achieved the Signum Virtutis Seal of Excellence 7-star Global Luxury Award. DoubleTree by Hilton Ras Al Khaimah was recognized among the best of the best within DoubleTree by Hilton in 2013. And the 2013 World Fastest Half Marathon times for both men and women were set in the Rack Half Marathon.
We'll be right back.
In 2013, Abu Dhabi had more than 2.8 million guests checked into the Emirates' 150 hotels and hotel apartments, a rise of 18% on 2012, and beating Abu Dhabi Tourism and Culture Authority's annual target of 2.5 million. The 2013 guest intake delivered close to 8.8 million guest nights, a 26% increase on 2012, with total revenue climbing 18% to 5.48 billion dirhams. The authority created a new dedicated one-stop entity to support the growth of exhibitions and conferences by forging closer links with the industry and providing financial and non-financial support. The authority expanded the successful trade engagement program with Etihad Airways to 5 new markets in 2013, taking the campaign's outreach to 10 countries across 4 continents. During its first year, Access Abu Dhabi progressed 38 destinations' co-marketing initiatives, undertook 10 destination familiarization trips for 755 travel agencies, 250 free independent travel agents and their staff, and completed successful partner engagement missions in our initial target markets. In 2013, the Etihad Airways Abu Dhabi Formula One Grand Prix sold out for the 5th year in a row. It was the fastest selling in the shortest period of time, with more than 55,000 fans from more than 80 countries attending the event. The authority launched the Emirates' official destination, a groundbreaking year for digital communications. The iPhone app for consumers, a comprehensive, easy-to-navigate online and offline mobile guide for all there is to see and do in Abu Dhabi. They also launched a stakeholder-focused corporate website, including a dedicated Abu Dhabi Convention Bureau website, the visitabudhabi.ae destination portal, and an array of cultural, tourism, and event-related websites. Their award-winning website was launched in Brazilian Portuguese language, taking the number of languages available to 9. The launch followed Etihad Airways' launch of direct flights to Sao Paulo from Abu Dhabi. Gourmet Abu Dhabi was billed as one of the world's best gourmet events. It was billed as one of the best 6 global gourmet events by Australia's Sydney Morning Herald. The destination launched Arabian Nights Village, the Emirates' first of its kind desert retreat, the UAE's first glamping, glamorous camping tourism product. Nestled in the dunes, the village was conceived to give guests a chance to experience the mythical and timeless beauty of the desert and traditional Emirati life. Abu Dhabi launched its largest water park, Yas Water World, at Yas Island, featuring some of the world's fastest and longest water slides. Centered around the theme of an Emirati pearl diving village and the legend of the lost pearl, the water park has 43 rides, slides, and attractions, and can welcome up to 6,000 people at a time. On Qasr al-Hosn's 250th anniversary, the authority launched the Qasr al-Hosn Festival, a heritage festival featuring all that Emiratis hold dear: pearl diving, falconry, crafts from the desert, the oasis, and the coast. The festival is an annual opportunity for the UAE community and visitors to experience the heritage of the Emirate through a variety of fun and educational activities, reflecting over 2.5 centuries of Emirati and Abu Dhabi history. 2013 has been a year of Sharjah achievements, accomplishments, and growth. Not only for Sharjah Commerce and Tourism Development Authority, but for the entire emirate. Visitor numbers increased throughout the year to 1.9 million, providing a strong platform for continued sustainable growth within the accommodation sector. Sharjah has successfully reached out to new markets in Asia, Europe, and America through a program of new roadshows, exhibitions, and innovative summits, including a UAE Korea Initiative, USA Roadshow, and a European Roadshow. The authority has been working strategically with other organizations, which resulted in Sharjah securing its most prestigious award and accolade to date. In 2012, Sharjah was announced as the Capital of Arab Tourism for 2015 by the Council of Arab Tourism Ministers. This year, the Organization of Islamic Cooperation officially crowned Sharjah as the Islamic Culture Capital for 2014. The huge celebrations across the emirate to mark the event have all contributed to achieving even further recognition of Sharjah as a destination for Arab and Islamic heritage and culture. Sharjah was also recognized by UNESCO as the Capital of Arab Culture in 1998. The emirate continues to host its world-class festivals, which include the stunning Sharjah Light Festival, Sharjah Water Festival, and World Powerboat Championship, Sharjah International Book Fair, and Sharjah Heritage Days. More than 5,000 cultural events are spread across the emirate every year. Sharjah has seen phenomenal growth in the tourism sector, most notably the Chetty Korfakan Resort, Kalba, and Sir Bunair's Island Ecotourism Initiatives. Alongside these, there are many new hotels opening, and more are on the way. Sharjah is dedicated to continuing to develop as a tourism destination with a difference. The message is clearly developing as the home of Arab and Islamic heritage and culture, guided by the vision and leadership of His Highness Dr. Sheikh Sultan bin Mohammed Al Qasimi, member of Supreme Council and ruler of Sharjah. The future for Sharjah looks strong and vibrant. Dubai has become the leading destination for families, events, and business. In 2013, Dubai's new and advanced hotel classification scheme became law, bringing it in line with international standard grading standards. The hotel industry has been given financial incentives to develop more mid-range hotels in Dubai in a move to augment the Emirates' supply of 3- and 4-star properties. DTCM opened its 4th office in China, a huge market for investment and tourism. DTCM and Dubai Taxi Corporation have signed a Memorandum of Understanding, agreeing to work together to improve customer service and taxi supply to support tourism sector growth. A decree was issued to create a fully integrated e-licensing and ticketing system for all events in Dubai, with the objective of supporting and developing the event sector and its contribution to the growth of tourism. DTCM is named as Tourism and Hospitality Company of the Year at the Gulf Business Industry Awards. Dubai won the bid to host Expo 2020. DTCM issued a decree to regulate the holiday homes market in the Emirate of Dubai. We saw the first phase of City Walk, a retail and entertainment indoor complex in Jumeirah One. 4 directives were announced to encourage increasing the supply of hotel rooms, particularly in the 3- and 4-star sector, in a timely fashion. Dubai was rated 23 on the list of top 52 places to go in 2014 by the New York Times, and was named 3rd most dynamic city in the world, with San Francisco and London, according to Jones Lang LaSalle. Dubai hotels welcome more than 11 million guests in 2013. Feature the rising star among the tourism destinations in the UAE, the Ajman Tourism Project. Ajman was number 2 on the list of best exhibitors in the Middle East and MENA at ITB Berlin. The department took home the top prize at the Riyadh Travel Fair in April 2013. They established the statistics system in May of 2013. The Ajman classification ceremony was established in July 2013. Ajman was entered in the Guinness Book of World Records for the largest mosaic in December 2013. In November, the Tourism Development Department launched the Mystery Shopper Audit Program for all Ajman hotels and hotel apartments to conclude by March 2014. Ajman Tourism Development Department won the Ajman Excellency Award Best Project for establishing and implementing the Hotel Classification Project.
الغرض من المشروع هو الارتقاء بالخدمات الفندقية.
الغرض من مشروع تصنيف المنشآت الفندقية هو الارتقاء بالخدمات المقدمة من قبل القطاع الفندقي بإمارة أجمان. هناك هدف استراتيجي واضح لجميع المعنيين بدائرة التنمية السياحية بإمارة أجمان، وهو وضع أسس وقوانين وشروط وأحكام متعلقة بتطوير قطاع السياحة بالإمارة. النتائج المتوقعة من مشروع تصنيف المنشآت الفندقية بإمارة عجمان كثيرة، لكن أهمها وهي مدى مصداقية نتائج التصنيف على المعنيين وهم سواح إمارة عجمان. لا يخفى على الجميع أن تصنيف المنشآت الفندقية هو النظرة الأولى أو السبب الرئيسي الأول لأي سائح لاختيار المنشآت الفندقية للإقامة فيها. لم يكن هذا الأمر متوفر سابقا، ولكن اليوم يتيح الفرصة لجميع نزلاء المنشآت الفندقية بإمارة عجمان للاطلاع على التصنيف وأيضا لمس هذا التصنيف ونتائجه على أرض الواقع.
I'm in the Emirate of Ajman for well over 10 years selling marketing hotels, leading one now, the Ajman Palace. And the Ajman Tourism Development Department has just delivered what we were looking for over 10 years. The hotel classification was implemented very fast in a very efficient manner by the team and will add a lot of credibility to a portfolio of well over 30 hotels in the Emirate of Ajman, giving us credibility on an international scale. We now are able to benchmark with hotels in other Emirates, not only in Abu Dhabi, in Dubai, or around the world based on the classification. Tourists buying their product on online travel agency websites today can see the hotel classification, our star rating, and they know it's backed by the authorities in Ajman, adding this credibility.
قيمة مضافة أخرى ممكن تحتسب لنتائج هذا المشروع هي إتاحة الفرصة للمستثمرين بالقطاع السياحي بمعرفة ما هي الفرص الاستثمارية المتوفرة بإمارة عجمان فيما يختص بقطاع الفندقي.
The introduction of the hotel classification system by the Ajman Tourism Development Department has been extremely well received by hoteliers and guests alike. Two things I would particularly like to mention and highlight is firstly the added services that have really well complemented our existing Kempinski services already in place, and on top of that, with the hotel classification standards, has really brought a local touch to our existing services and has been extremely well received by our customers. Secondly, it has managed to solidify the destination Ajman by on its own right with the classification system. We really can give the assurance to our international clients that Ajman is just on par with Dubai and Abu Dhabi. And when we talk about a four-star hotel, people know what they can expect. When we talk about a five-star hotel, such as Kempinski, people know what they expect. So we're really thankful for the Ajman Tourism Development Department for what they have done. And together, we continue to elevate our services and deliver service from the heart of Ajman, the charming emirate of the UAE.
Thank you. ladies and gentlemen. The violin sensation of the year. Four beautiful violinists with passion. Spirit. Ladies and gentlemen, the exclusive strings from Canada, Melissa Shack, Tamara Savic from Serbia, Marina Lopiasevic from Russia, and from Belgium, Larissa Lismore. The exclusive strings.
Evening at the MENA Awards. let's tell them what we do.
It was 2004. It was the year that Facebook was launched on the World Wide Web. What was originally created as a way for college kids to interact has now become a part of the daily lives of billions worldwide. 2004 was the year that Peter Jackson won the Academy Award for Best Director and for Best Picture for his screen adaptation of the J.R. Tolkien classic Lord of the Rings, Return of the King. On TV, one of the most successful TV shows of the 90s, Friends, aired its final episode. In music, Coldplay won Song of the Year at the Grammy Awards with their hit single, Clocks. And on May 6, 2004, almost exactly 10 years ago, the first annual Middle East and North Africa Travel Awards took place. The brainchild of Dr. Sam Saker, the awards gained instant credibility as they were determined by the actual end users of the product.
Well, the award system is based on votes of the people participating in this event. And our role actually is to ensure that the control and security on that system is working effectively to make sure that the votes are done appropriately, no duplicates, for instance, and the counting system is working perfectly.
Under the watchful eye of PricewaterhouseCoopers, the votes were tabulated, and in a glittering ceremony, the results were revealed. This is the 10th anniversary of the MENA Travel Awards. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the man behind the MENA Travel Awards, Sam Saker.
We're supposed to have some carnival music in the background here. We have the 10th annual anniversary celebration. It is the 10th year for the MENA Travel Awards. We made it that far with your support and with your contribution and with your competition spirit. But truly, I couldn't have made it that far without the partners who made it happen with me. Since 2004 until today, I would like to call the partners who really were behind the scene making the event happen, such as TechnoPro, the company that worked in our stage and lighting and sound for 10 years now. Crystal Arc, the company that has our trophies. Please join me on the stage. Crystal Arc, TechnoPro. Rashid Printers has made a great deal of contribution to the success as well with their quality printing every year for us. The TTN magazine, Kim Thompson, if you're around, I'd like you to come and cut the cake with me, please. TTN has been also a great team player with us throughout the year. Alhana Entertainment, if Marla is around, Marla, I would like you to come over and cut the cake with me. The 10th anniversary of MENA Travel Awards. Sincerely and from my heart, I'm very proud of all of you and what you have accomplished so far as individual hotels or other industry colleagues, and of course to the United Arab Emirates, ranking number 28 in the world today with their effort and the teamwork of all the tourism authorities that made it happen. Please give them a hand. Okay. So these are the players that made that event happen with me over the years, and I do appreciate all their contribution. I think Geraldine has something to say to you.
Thank you, Sam. In behalf of all the sponsors tonight, we are very happy, and it is Crystal Arc is our privilege to work hand in hand with Sam through all these years, through wonderful years of MENA Travel Awards. In celebration of this amazing 10th year, we would like to offer selective hotels in the MENA region to one of our most amazing art pieces, as you can see in the stage. And with this said, this is no cost to the hotel. And we as a team in Crystal Arc, we will be calling those hotels after the show. With that said, thank you so much. We look forward and enjoy the evening. Thank you. Thank you, Sam.
Thank you very much. Well, with the presence of all the team members here, I would like to have a knife so we can all together. Cut the cake? Yeah, it's okay. I'm not going to eat anymore. Yeah, come. Okay. Thank you. Start the evening. First, with the appreciation and all our thanking statement that can ever be made to welcome with us tonight His Excellency Sheikh Abdulaziz Al-Nuaimi, Chairman of Ajman Tourism Development Department. And along with his side, Mr. Faisal Al-Nuaimi, General Manager of Ajman Tourism Development Department. We're also honored tonight to have with us from Sharjah, His Excellency Mr. Mohammed Al-Noman, Chairman, Sharjah Commerce and Tourism Development Authority. And next to him, of course, Mr. Khalid Al-Matfa,
General Manager of Sharjah Commerce and Tourism Development Authority. And we're honored also to have with us from Dubai, His Excellency Issam Kazim, CEO, DCTCM, alongside with Mr. Saleh Al-Ghazeri, Director of Overseas Offices. And from Abu Dhabi, we're honored to have with us Mr. Mubarak Al-Nuaimi, Abu Dhabi Tourism and Culture Authority. And from Ras Al Khaimah, we're honored to have with us today also Mr. Steve Rice, CEO of Ras Al Khaimah Tourism Authority. And for the first time, we have with us Mr. Saeed Al-Samahi, General Manager of Fujairah Tourism and Antiquities Authority. Not to mention that we are very honored tonight to have with us our upcoming guest speaker, Mr. Rudy Jagisbeker, President of Middle East and Africa, Hilton Worldwide. We also have another honor of having with us Mr. Sami Nasser, the Vice President of Middle East and Africa for Fairmont Hotels. Say, the future belongs to those who believe in their beautiful dreams. While we are inside the picture, we don't see much of it. But if we all step out and look at the big picture of the United Arab Emirates, you will see this statement is true. The future belongs to those who believe in their beautiful dreams. And that is what the United Arab Emirates, with the driving energy and engines behind it, with the Tourism Authority's effort, have achieved the highest ranking results in 2013. Tonight, we celebrate that. We'll celebrate for the coming next three segments, and we'll celebrate for the rest of the year all the effort that was done by United Arab Emirates and all of the tourism authorities with us tonight. Please give them a hand. Quick news for this year before we have our honorable guest speaker. This year, we had over 1,200 enrollments, out of which over 200 nominees were selected after the voting process and audit. This year we had over 500,000 votes, that's of course including the first, second, and third choice. The competition this year were probably in the 10th anniversary with the toughest ever since we started this year, between all the entrants in the various categories. Unfortunately, and this has not happened for the last couple of years. It happened before, but unfortunately, PricewaterhouseCoopers, we had to terminate seven of the entities for issues with the false votes. There is no tolerance in the voting system we have created 10 years ago with PricewaterhouseCoopers. Everybody comes on the stage is well-deserved because the entity was selected by the end user with a very accurate voting system that have ethics and integrity, and we will maintain that for your sake and for the image of our company and PricewaterhouseCoopers. We will always make sure that everybody that is coming to the stage has been duly deserved and selected by the end users. We also, as a result of the high competition this year, we have few ties in different categories. And we look forward to an exciting night while we celebrate first the United Arab Emirates successes in the first two segments of the categories of the awards, and then the rest of the leaders of quality, service quality and product quality in the region. So at this time, I would like to invite our first guest speaker, and the only guest speaker tonight, Mr. Rudy Jagisbeker. Please join us on the stage for your word of wisdom. Thank you.
Uh, Hey, Sam, before you go, where are the dancing girls? Okay, great. Okay. Your Excellency, honored guests, ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to celebrate with you the 10th anniversary of the MENA Travel Awards. And of course, I'd like to welcome you to the Conrad, one of our latest luxury hotels in Dubai. Hard to believe 10 years have passed, and it seems like yesterday. I was in Dubai in the first MENA award ceremony, and I'd like you to join me in congratulating Sam's vision and insight to honor the best and the brightest of our industry. So Sam, a big hand for you, come on. I think the only difference is between 10 years ago, Sam and I had lots more hair and they were not gray. I wouldn't do my job if I wouldn't talk about Hilton for just a couple of minutes. We have been in the region for over 50 years. We have 5 brands within the UAE and the Middle East. Everybody knows our core brand, Hilton Hotels and Resorts. But of course, our new brands are now coming in. DoubleTree by Hilton, Hilton Garden Inn, the Conrad as we have today, and of course, one of the most legendary hotels we have in the chain, the Waldorf Astoria, which is now open in Ras Al Khaimah, in Jeddah, and the Palm Jumeirah, and hopefully more to come. Interestingly, we presently open 66 hotels, and we have 67 new hotels in the pipeline. But more on a global, we're always talking about the UAE and the Middle East. I want to also share with you actually the world of Hilton, because since 2007, when Hilton International got together with Hilton Worldwide, we grew by 35%, and we have now 4,100 hotels on the globe with 10 brands, which I think is one of the biggest companies which we now have available. But I want to make sure that this big is not always the best. So we are more than just a business. We have over 300,000 global team members operating in 91 different countries, and not only focused on satisfying the need of our guests, but also demonstrating their passion for hospitality within their local communities. To harness this enthusiasm and passion, we launched Travel with a Purpose, a program to address the social, economic, sustainable issues that impact our business and are important to our communities. We believe it's our duty to tackle the challenges, seize the opportunity that are bigger than we are, and help to create shared values for our businesses. I think it's important to give something back and not just only take. So we call every year the Week of Global Service, where more than 100,000 team members volunteer with over 800 communities which spans across 51 countries. I truly believe that giving back to the communities is really important. I am aware of the abundance and the need where we do business. However, even small returns and actions have a high return. I share with you this commitment, and I want to encourage and support with all of you community engagement. I stand here before you because being part, I'm really proud of being part of this community and this industry. Being proud of being a trailblazer in this room. For more than 10 years, driven our region to extraordinary heights. AHEC, ATM, also have 10 years. And you have seen over the last few days the bright light of our success, our growth and opportunities, and our potential within the region. The airlines have paved the way to the routes to other markets, and our hotels have given them the opportunity to do business and explore and relax. Believe it or not, tourists today spend in MIA more than $97 billion. And this will continue on a growth of 17% over the next 2 years. The success in the Middle East isn't by any chance. It is because we have attracted and developed and retained extraordinary people locally and internationally. When Sam told me about the theme of today's ceremony, powered by service quality, I thought about not necessarily profit. I thought about our team members. By quality, I mean extraordinary attention to detail, going beyond the expected, delivering more than we promise, and to develop a long-term relationship with our stakeholders. Surely that is the difference between great teams and ordinary teams. That extra determines whether you are on the road to success or you don't know where the road begins or ends. Someone once told me that to create an extraordinary team, you would have to look for a very distinctive trail that divides the extraordinary from the ordinary people. I'd like to think that we talk about being extraordinary by staying extraordinary as an inspiration to our industry. However, we have a duty to look to our teams, to choose the extraordinary by commitment. You're committing yourselves to excellence and high standards, who live and work those values, and the action speaks for themselves. We must believe in our brands and products and services and understand how unique and valuable they are towards our companies, our communities, and our overall success, which will stand out amongst the rest. What is important for us as an industry is to continue to build teams, to promote a positive and realistic understanding. Teams must understand to be financially successful, we must be creative, innovative, and extraordinary, sustain and grow our businesses. Being extraordinary is something that requires a daily commitment. It requires discipline, and the result is a better business platform that generates increased guest satisfaction and, of course, make no mistake, it's all about profitability. If you look at some extraordinary people who have changed the way we do business, look at Bill Gates with Microsoft. Look at the founder of Tesla Motor. Look at Steve Jobs, Zuckerberg, and many, many more. Those people are examples how commitment to innovation and quality can inspire people, change the way we work and communicate, improve our operations, and sustain sustainable growth. Think about what all the things which we have achieved in the last 10 years, the services which we now provide, the people we attract into this region, and of course, the revenues which we now generate. We all want a piece of cake of that. Having a team with the right attitude, however, the discipline and belief, the willingness to learn, is the difference between known as a successful business or not. Let us aspire to pursue quality and to be extraordinary, and encourage those to follow you. Some of the most successful people in our industry were identified in the very early stage to have extraordinary potential. They progressed with directions, leadership, and support. I am sure we all know these young and up-and-coming stars, high potential team members who should be our future hospitality leaders. I encourage you to motivate, support them throughout the career, as you need to look for your successors already today. Enough of the past. We have so much to look forward for the next 10 years. And also, we need to do an extraordinary job in supporting our key stakeholders. But most important, don't forget your families. I am pleased with you to celebrate we're here tonight and being and creating an industry of being extraordinary. Thank you and have a good evening.
Your Excellency.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Good evening. My name is Tim Klassen.
And my name is Bex Tiani, and we are your hosts for this evening. And to celebrate, Tim, the 10th anniversary tonight, there is an after party that's taking place at the Latin American nightclub, Easel. Will you be going, Tim?
With bells on, yes.
And ladies and gentlemen, all winners this evening, we request that they remain on stage for the group awards photograph. Again, right at the end of the evening.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the MENA Travel Awards for 2014, the 10th anniversary awards this year.
And this year, it's the Powered by Service Quality Awards.
Tonight, we'll once again celebrate the hospitality best service and product quality champions in the Middle East and North Africa region. Now, being neutral and an honorable guest of tonight's ceremony, Ms. Claire Seneca will receive the top three runner-up sealed envelopes from our via PricewaterhouseCoopers.
These front runners have virtuously been selected this year by over 170,000 voters, thank you, of the industry's end users, guests, and clients, adding up to over 510,000 voters when calculating the 18 categories.
So I can open it now? I didn't even get clear anything. I feel bad. Ladies and gentlemen, our first category is Best UAE Tourism Authority. The ongoing successes and incredible achievements of the UAE in the world of travel and tourism are, without a doubt, attributed to the UAE Tourism Authority's combined efforts. UAE tourism plans and efforts contributed impressively over 14% to the economy in 2013, which compares to the global trend of 10%.
And this trend continues in the future through the UAE Tourism Authority's marketing strategies and efforts, which are certainly essential to further raise the UAE ranking and increase the number of visitors to the country. Please join us to applaud these exceptional performances.
The nominees for Best UAE Tourism Authority:
Sharjah Commerce and Tourism Development Authority,
Ajman Tourism Development Department,
Dubai Department of Tourism and Commerce Marketing,
Abu Dhabi Tourism and Culture Authority,
Ras Al Khaimah Tourism Authority.
First up, the Silver Award. Now, until recent times, Ras Al Khaimah was one of the world's best-kept secrets. However, word is rapidly spreading that Ras Al Khaimah is a must-visit destination for any traveler seeking a unique experience that combines luxury with relaxation, tranquility, and natural beauty. Ras Al Khaimah is one of the most consistently inhabited places on Earth, with over 7,000 years of inhabitation and, of course, a rich and diverse history.
And the Best Tourism Authority is sponsored by the UAE NCTA. And with 65 kilometers of unspoilt virgin beaches that can rival any beach resort throughout the world, this majestic Hadja Mountains rise to almost 2,000 meters and offer beautiful landscapes and spectacular views in abundance. And now, with 5,000 hotel rooms, most of which are five-star beach resorts, and with the world's class brands such as the Banyan Tree, the Rixos, Hilton, and not forgetting the iconic Waldorf Astoria Hotel, Ras Al Khaimah is now reaching for the stars.
The winner of silver, the Ras Al Khaimah Tourism Authority. Guided by the vision of the Emirates leadership, Sharjah has been recognized by organizations across the globe and has a distinct position within world tourism. In 2013, Sharjah has been selected as the capital of Arab tourism for 2015, while in 2014, Sharjah's crowning as the capital of Islamic culture has helped to further recognize its unique features. Even before all of these prestigious awards, Sharjah was awarded the UNESCO Tourism Award in 1998.
The authorities have raised public awareness locally, regionally, and internationally, focusing on Sharjah's tourism experience and presenting it as a world-class tourism destination, applauding the authentic Arab and Islamic culture for which Sharjah is renowned. So the Gold Award goes to Sharjah Commerce and Tourism Development Authority.
Thank you. have a two-way tie for platinum. Our next award goes to an organization that is central to delivering an extremely ambitious target for Dubai to become the world's most visited city. 1 year ago, Dubai launched its tourism vision for 2020, and the headline of welcoming 20 million visitors per year by the end of the decade. It is the role of Dubai's Department of Tourism and Commerce Marketing to harness the collective power of the industry stakeholders, including government and private entities, to achieve this target. In the last few days, DTCM has been outlining the significant steps that have been taken towards 2020 since the tourism vision was announced.
Major milestones such as the winning of Expo 2020 and the opening of what will become the world's largest airport. Legislative changes such as federal amends to visa regulations for EU member states and new regulations that will encourage and a substantial number of new hotels, new attractions, and new events have all been noted by DTCM. And this week has also seen DTCM launch a new marketing blueprint that will show the world that Dubai's landmark developments and rise from fishing village to modern metropolis may have earned its reputation as a must-see destination. It is the remarkable collection of activities and experiences throughout the Emirates that will see this change from must-see to destination that must be experienced.
Our first platinum award in this category goes to Dubai Department of Tourism and Commerce Marketing. Sharing the top honor with Dubai is an organization that does more than just market its home destination. It lives up to a mandate to conserve and promote its heritage and culture and leverages them to a development of a world-class sustainable destination with distinction. Abu Dhabi Tourism and Culture Authority manages the Emirates tourism sector and markets the destination internationally through a wide range of activities aimed at attracting visitors and investment.
Its policies, plans, and programs relate to the preservation of heritage and culture, and with protecting archaeological and historic sites and developing museums, including the Louvre in Abu Dhabi and Zayed National Museum and the Guggenheim in Abu Dhabi, which will open from next year onwards. The authorities support intellectual and artistic activities and cultural events to nurture a rich cultural environment and honor the Emirates' heritage in all close cooperation with its wide-ranging stakeholders. And for the Platinum Award, it goes to Abu Dhabi Tourism and Culture Authority. Next category, Best Tourism Projects. Tourism Authority projects, plans, and efforts contribute a great deal to their country's successes and positioning in both regional and international markets. In the past three decades, we've witnessed over 30% growth in tourism projects in the region. Whether may they be mega projects or step-up projects, they all contribute to the country's achievement and end results. Many countries in this region are helping to ensure this trend continues in the future by investing heavily in tourism projects. The tourism authorities' firm strategies are certainly essential to bring in the highest number of visitors in any given city or any country.
The nominees for Best Tourism Project:
Taba Heights, Egypt;
Alguna Red Sea, Egypt;
Ajman Tourism Development Department;
Master Ji Ki Haveli, Delhi.
And the sponsor for Best Tourism Project category is UAE NCTA. Being an emerging tourism destination in the UAE and the region, Ajman Tourism Development Department not only established its first classification system, for which it won Best Government Project as part of Ajman Excellence Program 2013, Ajman Tourism Development Department also stabilized its comprehensive statistics system for the hospitality sector in a mega project through which it worked hard with its partners in the various tourism projects.
2013 is Ajman Tourism Development Department's second working year, during which they were recognized regionally as the best exhibitor in the 5th Riyadh Travel Fair, internationally by the second best exhibitor for the Middle East and Near East region in ITB Berlin, and concluded 2013 by winning the World Guinness Book Records for the largest mosaic greeting card as part of the UAE Day celebrations.
At this time, I'd like to introduce His Excellency Faisal Al Nuaimi, the General Manager of Ajman Tourism Development Department. Like to welcome His Highness Sheikh Abdulaziz bin Hamid Al Nuaimi as well. Thank you. Ajman Trophy, Best Five-Star Hotel, is Kempinski Hotel Ajman. Best four-star hotel
Hello. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, Tim Bextra, for such impressive introduction about Ajman. I would like to thank His Highness Sheikh Abdulaziz bin Hamid Al Nuaimi, the Chairman of Ajman Tourism Development Department, for his continued support for all ATTD operations and eagerness for making it easier for many corporate and legislative initiatives that always lead and really serve the acceleration of development of the various tourism sectors in the Emirate of Ajman in specific and UAE in general. Your Highness, today we have completed 28 months of operation. After setting up our corporate identity, structure, and infrastructure, from day one, we were eager to take responsibility and work very hard in parallel and several levels, segments, to fulfill the requirements for the development of all tourism-related sectors in Ajman. The results and that we know have 7 Amiri decrees have been issued and legalization organizing the development of the various sectors of Ajman tourism. Moving ahead with our eye looking forward towards the needs and requirements of our wide range stakeholders, customers, and the community, and investors, our strategic partners, policymakers, and organizers, our customers who range from tourists coming from foreign countries to GCC, visitors and local tourists. All the segments represent the focal point of all our initiatives, projects, and daily efforts. And we promise you, Your Highness, to continue on the road serving our beloved Emirate Ajman. I wanted to take a moment to say how much the Ajman Tourism Development Department team appreciated the great insight you afforded us. Thank you, Your Highness, for the outstanding leadership you provided us. It will have a major impact on guiding our work in the year ahead. Now, it's time to add a new achievement by announcing the winners of Ajman Tourism Development Department Award 2014. The first round of the award was mainly sponsored by CHA International, the organizer of the MENA Travel Award. Ajman Award was established and built on the results of the Mr. Shobar project, which was launched a few months ago and monitored 13 hotels and 20 hotel apartments. I'm inviting His Highness Sheikh Abdulaziz Mohammed Al Naimi, the Chairman of Ajman Tourism and Development Department, to the stage, along with Dr. Sam Saker, to announce the winners, please.
The winner for Best 5-Star Hotel, Kempinski Hotel, Ajman. The award goes to Ramada Beach Hotel. Star Hotel, the Crown Palace Hotel. Once again, the best 2-star hotel, Crown Palace Hotel. The winner for Best 1-Star Hotel, the Ajman Beach Hotel. Next, we have the best superior hotel apartment, UNHA. Best Standard Hotel Apartment, Sarah H.A. Thank you very much, Your Highness. Sheikh Abdulaziz bin Hamad Al Naimi, and of course, Mr. Faisal as well. Thank you very much. Hotel apartment. Going once. Going twice.
They have already arrived at the after party, Tim. That's where they're all at.
At the after party.
Well, we now move on to a special recognition award for this year.
The Future Vision Award, CHA MENA Travel Awards, and the auditing firm established the Future Vision Award in 2014 to recognize industry professionals and sector bodies who have achieved or exceeded their intended expectations and represented a significant contribution in tourism in the given communities and country. The award celebrates what have been successfully implemented and have improved the quality for the tourism community. The recipient of the Future Vision Award is carefully selected and recognized by MENA Awards and the Audit Firm Committee with endorsements from CHA International Consultants.
Sharjah has seen a phenomenal growth in the tourism sector and high-profile projects, Chetty Khorfakkan Resort, Kalba, and Sir Bonaire Islands Tico Tourism Initiatives being the most notable. Alongside these, there are many other new hotels opening, and with more on the way. The future is definitely looking positive for Sharjah. It is without a doubt that Sharjah is indeed continuing the growth, while the solid foundations that have been well laid ensures that Sharjah will confidently compete on the global scale.
Sharjah is dedicated to continuing the development of the tourism destination with a distinct, and its message is clearly developing as the home of Arab and Islamic heritage and culture. Guided by the vision and the leadership of His Highness Dr. Sheikh Sultan bin Mohammed Al Qassimi, member of Supreme Council and ruler of Sharjah, the future for Sharjah is compelling.
The leader and driver behind a Sharjah vision, he's been involved in tourism in the Emirate of Sharjah for nearly 15 years. Considered an expert in Middle East tourism and is responsible for driving through numerous initiatives and positive changes. He's witnessed remarkable growth during his tenure with the SCTDA from a few hundred thousand tourists 10 years ago to nearly 2 million arrivals today. His proven leadership and management style has enabled the vision of His Highness the ruler of Sharjah to develop within the industry resilient, affirmative, sustainable, and managed methods, with focus on strategic direction and solid growth targets of SCTDA.
Being a strong and passionate advocate for tourism, he is well recognized and a sought-after speaker. He believes in progressively managing growth whilst ensuring that Sharjah tourism product remains authentic and valuable for many generations to come. As well as being chairman of Sharjah Commerce and Tourism Development Authority, he is also a member of the Sharjah Executive Council and sits on the board of the Sharjah Media Corporation and is also involved in many other government and non-government organizations.
Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming His Excellency Mr. Muhammad Ali Al Noman, chairman of the Sharjah Commerce and Tourism Development Authority, to receive Sharjah Future Vision Award. Brooklyn. One of the ways that companies are able to cope with challenging economic conditions is to become more cost-effective in their daily operations. Offering favorable rates but maintaining high-quality standards has become more difficult but much more appreciated. It's not about cheaper rates, but rather better value for money.
These nominated hotels have managed to find that delicate balance between turning a profit and turning away customers.
The nominees for Best Price Value Hotel:
Grand Millennium Dubai,
Holiday Inn Express Dubai Airport,
Radisson Blue Hotel Cairo Heliopolis,
Tulip Inn Altaif,
Andalusia Hotel Riyadh,
Hilton Taba Resort in Nelson Village,
Holiday Inn Express Dubai Internet City,
City Max Hotels Dubai,
Coral Suites Alhambra,
Corp Executive Al Khoury Hotel Dubai,
Millennium Hotel Doha,
Golden Tulip Qasr Al Baha,
Concorde Hotel Fujairah,
Ramada Beirut Downtown,
Tamani Marina Hotel and Hotel Apartment Dubai,
Mangrove Hotel by Bin Majid Hotels and Resorts.
And the sponsor for the Best Price Value Hotel is PricewaterhouseCoopers. And the winners: the first silver goes to the Mangrove Hotel by Bin Majid Hotels and Resorts. The second silver is awarded to... The second silver is awarded to City Max Hotels Dubai. Our gold award in this category is awarded to the Hilton Taba Resort and Nelson Village. The Platinum Award goes to the Grand Millennium Dubai. Thank you.
category is Best Spa. Working in this region can be very rewarding, but it's important to find a way to offset the stresses and general pace of life here. That's why it's so important to have a place to unwind. For a growing number of people, a trip to the spa is the perfect place to do that.
Over the past couple of years, we've seen an increase in the number of standalone operations and hotel spas. We've also seen a growing number of men enjoying spa facilities, Tim.
The nominees for Best Spa:
The Lounge Spa Ras Al Khaimah,
Sofitel The Palm Dubai,
Millennium Hotel Amman,
Alarine Palace and Spa Manama,
Grand Millennium Dubai,
Sofitel Bahrain Zalak Thalassa Sea and Spa,
JW Marriott Cairo,
The Ritz-Carlton Doha,
Wyndham Grand Regency Doha,
Grand Millennium Al Wada Abu Dhabi.
And the Best Spa category is sponsored by Crystal Arc. Let me get the envelope here. Our first silver, JW Marriott Cairo. Our gold award goes to Grand Millennium Dubai. Award goes to Sofitel The Palm Dubai. Category, Best Car Rental Local Brand. Now, the past few years have been challenging for car rental companies in the region. Many, however, have turned a negative into a positive by appealing to expat residents who are unsure of their long-term plans.
Tonight, we recognize those companies who have continued to be very competitive while maintaining service excellence thanks to excellent and creative marketing strategies.
The nominees for Best Car Rental Local Brand:
Impala Rent-A-Car,
Altala International Transportation Company Limited, Hanco Jeddah,
Al Mufta Rental Car Doha,
Fast Rent-A-Car UAE.
And the Best Car Rental Local Brand has been sponsored by CHA International, and the winners are: for silver, Altala International Transport, Hanco Jeddah.
Thank you.
Gold has been awarded to Fast Rent-A-Car in Abu Dhabi. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome onto the stage our gold winners, Fast Rent-A-Car in Abu Dhabi. Platinum has been awarded to Al Mufta Rent-A-Car in Doha.
And convention center. Conferences and conventions mean multiple flights and multiple hotel bookings, as well as supporting many spin-off industries as well. So it's no surprise that many governments across the region are investing heavily in their conference and convention facilities.
New facilities in the Middle East and North Africa are state-of-the-art and now lead the world with regards to infrastructure, equipment, and presentation tools.
The nominees for Best Conference Convention Center:
Riyadh Marriott Hotel,
Meritim Jolieville International Congress Center, Sharm El Sheikh,
Hilton Abu Dhabi,
Holiday Inn Al Qasr Hotel, Riyadh,
Cairo International Convention Center,
King Hussein Bin Talal Convention Center, managed by Hilton.
The Best Conference Convention Center has been sponsored by Technopro.
And the winner of silver is the Riyadh Marriott Hotel. Conference Convention Center, King Hussein Bin Talal Convention Center, managed by Hilton. category, Best Car Rental International Brand. The Middle East region has become a heavily competitive market for car rental companies. Customers are increasingly using the internet to find the best values, and companies are having to come up with innovative strategies to remain competitive in markets where all major car rental international brands are represented.
The continuing proliferation of other car rental and leasing operations have made it more challenging to stand out, and this in this environment. But the following operators have managed to do just that.
The nominees for Best Car Rental International Brand:
Avis Rental Car, Egypt.
Unique SA Luxury Prestige Cars:
Hertz Car Rental, Dubai.
Budget Rent-A-Car, Jeddah.
And the Best Car Rental International Brand category is sponsored by CHA International.
And the gold is awarded to Hertz Car Rental in Dubai. Budget Rent-A-Car in Jeddah. That there is at right at the very end, the group photograph. So please do remain with us for that monumental photo. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage Budget Rent-A-Car in Jeddah.
Our next category is Best Five-Star Leisure Hotel. Well, tourists aren't the only ones making use of the region's leisure facilities, as many residents find refuge from the daily grind as they recharge their batteries while not straying too far from home.
And this trend has helped properties remain viable in the face of challenging conditions and increased competition.
The nominees for Best Five-Star Leisure Hotel:
Al Maha, a luxury collection, Desert Resort and Spa, Dubai.
Crown Plaza Resort, Salalah.
Ajman Saray.
Waldorf Astoria, Dubai, Palm Jumeirah.
Sofitel, The Palm, Dubai.
Hilton Pyramids Golf Resort.
Taj Palace Hotel, Dubai.
Hilton Luxor Resort and Spa.
Kempinski Hotel, Ajman.
Sofitel Essaouira Mogador Golf and Spa.
Al Ayn Palace and Spa, Manama.
Hilton Ras Al Khaimah Resort and Spa.
Park Hyatt Abu Dhabi Hotel and Villas.
The Ajman Palace Hotel.
Mövenpick Hotel, Beirut.
Sofitel Al Khobar, The Corniche.
Kempinski Hotel and Residences, Palm Jumeirah.
Radisson Blue Resort, Fujairah.
And the sponsor of the Best Five-Star Leisure Hotel is CHA International.
And the first silver, we have a two-way tie. First silver goes to the Hilton Ras Al Khaimah Resort and Spa.
Thank you.
The second silver goes to the Hilton Luxor Resort and Spa. Two-way tie for gold. The first gold goes to the Ajman Saray. Second gold winner goes to the Almaha, a luxury resort, desert resort, and spa, Dubai. Star Leisure Hotel, the Waldorf Astoria, Dubai, Palm Jumeirah.
Congratulate to all of our first eight categories on their winnings. Congratulations and well done. Sam, thank you very much. We're going to be taking 20 minutes with our entertainers now. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome back to the stage the entertainers of Exclusive Strings.
Thank you. and gentlemen, may I have a big round of applause for Marina Lepesevich from Russia, from the Netherlands, Daniela von Bergam, from Serbia, Tamar Savic, and from Canada, Melissa Jacques. Ladies and gentlemen, the exclusive strings.
Continue with the awards. The best four-star business corporate category. YouGov's Oracle reported last year that more than 2 in 5 travelers reported an increase in business travel from an average of 35% in 2011 to 41% in 2012 and 42% last year. And statistics from a research firm Euromonitor International reveal steady growth increases in business arrivals across 4 key MENA markets between now and 2016.
Corporate and business services are becoming standard procedures in most hotels. Companies are now utilizing new technology and a wide selection of business tools to make themselves an obvious choice for today's business traveler.
Ramada Sharjah,
Al Waha Palace Hotel Riyadh,
Courtyard Riyadh Diplomatic Quarter,
Golden Tulip Bereda Hotel,
Holiday Inn Al-Kabar, Corniche,
Hilton Cairo Zamalek Residences,
Acacia Hotel by Bin Majid Hotels and Resorts,
4 Points by Sheraton Sheikh Zayed Road, Dubai,
Copthorne Hotel, Dubai,
Golden Tulip Al-Nasiriyah,
Ramada Hotel, Dubai,
Radisson Blue Hotel, Dubai Dira Creek,
Casablanca Hotel, Jeddah,
Ramada Jumeirah Hotel,
Holiday Inn, Dubai, Al-Barsha,
Coral Dira Hotel, Dubai,
Holiday Inn Al-Qasr Hotel, Riyadh,
Golden Tulip, Hale,
Al-Kazama Hotel, a Rosewood Hotel, Riyadh,
Millennium Airport Hotel, Dubai.
And the best four-star business corporate hotel category sponsored by Hospitality.
And the first silver award goes to the Holiday Inn Dubai Al-Barsha.
Thank you.
silver goes to Ramada Sharja. The platinum goes to the 4 points by Sheraton at Sheikh Zayed Road, Dubai.
Platinum Award for Best Cheering Section also goes to the 4 points as well. Our next category is the Best Golf Club. Well, golf is undoubtedly the most popular form of corporate entertainment. It's a sport that can be enjoyed by the very young and the very old. And its handicap system allows players of different skill levels to compete with each other on the course.
The other reason that golf is so attractive to corporate types is only a small portion of the time is actually spent or devoted to the game itself, allowing for numerous opportunities to discuss business.
The nominees for Best Golf Club:
Doha Golf Club,
JW Marriott Cairo,
Royal Marrakesh Golf Club,
Al Muj Golf,
Al Wali Golf Club,
Al Guna Golf Course.
And the Best Golf Club category is sponsored by Crystal Arc. The gold winner is Al Muj Golf Muscat Oman. Golf Club, the JW Marriott Cairo. Category is the best five-star new hotel. Well, Egypt continues to feel the effects of the uprising in 2012, but they showed a 17% increase in travelers 2013 alongside the rest of the countries in the MENA region who've registered record similar gains. They've managed to enjoy modest gains despite economic uncertainty and increased competition.
Although many companies and individuals are looking for ways for more cost-effective, there is still a substantial demand for more upscale offerings at reasonable prices.
The nominees for Best Five-Star New Hotel:
Renaissance Cairo, Mirage City Hotel,
Waldorf Astoria Dubai Palm Jumeirah,
Conrad Dubai,
Waldorf Astoria Ras Al Khaimah,
Sofitel The Palm Dubai,
the Ajman Palace Hotel,
and Antara Dubai, the Palm Resort and Spa.
And the Best Five-Star New Hotel category is sponsored by CHA International.
And the first silver award goes to the Renaissance Cairo Mirage City Hotel. The second silver goes to the Waldorf Astoria Ras Al Khaimah.
I think there may be some people from here. Our next category is Best Fine Dining Restaurant, Middle East and North Africa. Well, they say that the way to a man's heart is through his stomach, and many properties are finding it's also the way to their wallet. By providing a variety of quality dining facilities within their establishments, operators are ensuring that their customers and their hard-earned cash aren't walking out the door.
The Middle East and North Africa have proven to be the best, both in terms of variety and service standards. Nowhere else in the world will you find such a varied selection of cuisine in one place or in one hotel.
The nominees for Best Fine Dining Restaurant:
Garana, Holiday Inn, Dubai, Al Barsha.
Rangila, Indian Restaurant at Copthorne Hotel, Dubai.
The Royal Buddha at Holiday Inn, Dubai, Al Barsha.
Ginger Restaurant at Ramada Jumeirah.
Handy at Taj Palace Hotel, Dubai.
Toshi at Grand Millennium, Dubai.
JW Steakhouse at JW Marriott, Cairo.
Porto Bello at Grand Millennium Al Wada, Abu Dhabi.
Noodles Corner Restaurant at Mangrove Hotel by Bin Majid Hotels and Resorts.
Terrace Grill at Riyadh Marriott Hotel.
Saffron Restaurant at Al Arin Palace and Spa, Manama.
Bukhara at Kempinski Hotel Ajman.
Social by Heinz Beck, Waldorf Astoria, Dubai, Palm Jumeirah.
La Mer at Ritz-Carlton, Doha.
Aromi, Waldorf Astoria, Jeddah, Qasr Al Sharq.
And the Best Fine Dining category is sponsored by CHA International. Our silver winner is Bukhara at Kempinski Hotel Ajman. Our gold winner for Best Fine Dining Restaurant, Toshi at Grand Millennium Dubai. Winner in the Best Fine Dining Restaurant category, JW Steakhouse at JW Marriott Cairo. Our next category, Best Environmental Hotel. The hospitality industry has done a pretty good job of recognizing the impact that they have on the environment and has implemented a number of programs to help minimize that impact.
The overall awareness of environment and sustainability issues has increased as people become more passionate about the environment. And the demand for eco-friendly tourism continues to go up. Tonight, we honor those who've done a great job at giving back to planet Earth.
The nominees for Best Environmental Hotel:
Corp Executive, Al Khoury Hotel, Dubai.
Hilton Sharjah.
Coral Beach Rotana Resort, Hurghada.
Movenpick Resort, El Kasser.
Ramada Hotel and Suites, Ajman.
Beach Resort by Bin Majid Hotels and Resorts.
Hilton Beirut, Hoptor Grand.
Le Meridien Al Aqqa Beach Resort.
Tamani Marina Hotel and Hotel Apartment, Dubai.
Kempinski Hotel Ajman.
The Ajman Palace Hotel.
Sofitel The Palm, Dubai.
Park Hyatt, Abu Dhabi Hotel and Villas.
And the sponsor for the Best Environmental Star Hotel is TTN. And the silver winner goes to the Ramada Hotel and Suites Ashman.
Felt like I was at the World Cup in Brazil just now. Now I know why the cheer was so loud. Definitely not going to do a selfie of this group unless we can find a guy with an arm that's like 15 feet long.
And the second silver for the best environmental star hotel goes to... the Tamani Marina Hotel and Hotel Apartments, Dubai. Our first gold award goes to the Hilton Sharjah. Goes to the Hilton Beirut Haptor Grand. Platinum Award goes to Le Méridien Al Aqqa Beach Resort.
Well,
Ladies and gentlemen, we remind you all that on the 10th anniversary, there is an after party tonight. And do join us. And of course, at the end of the show, we're wanting all award winners back on the stage for a group photograph. Tim.
Our next category, Best Four-Star New Hotel. Well, there have been many positive economic indicators lately, and while this is definitely a reason for optimism, many of us are guardedly optimistic and continue to keep an eye on spending.
As many of us try to do more with less, the demand for quality for four-star hotels has increased substantially.
The nominees for Best Four-Star New Hotel:
Copthorne Hotel, Sharjah;
Novotel Dubai Al Barsha;
Golden Tulip, Dammam Corniche Hotel.
The Best Four-Star New Hotel for the year 2013 is sponsored by CHA International.
And our first silver winner in this category, Golden Tulip Dammam Corniche Hotel. Winner in this category, the Copthorne Hotel Sharjah. Our new hotel, the Novotel Dubai Al Barsha. Our next category, Best Conference Convention Hotel. Well, capitalizing on its expanding hotel industry and state-of-the-art infrastructure, the Middle East and North Africa is rapidly becoming one of the world's best sought-after conference and convention destinations in the world.
Hotels in the Middle East and North Africa are keen on exceeding the expectations of business travelers and making sure that all conference and convention facilities are there to serve their needs.
The nominees for Best Conference Convention Hotel:
Dusit Thani Lakeview, Cairo;
La Royal Meridian, Abu Dhabi;
Jeddah Hilton;
Concord Hotel, Fujairah;
Hilton, Doha;
the Ajman Palace Hotel;
Conrad, Dubai.
And the Best Conference Convention Hotel category is sponsored by Rashid Printers. The silver award goes to the Dusit Thani Lakeview, Cairo.
Thank you.
The Gold Award goes to Le Royal Meridian Abu Dhabi. And our platinum winner for Best Conference Convention Hotel, the Conrad Dubai. Next category, Best Four-Star Leisure Hotel. Uncompromisingly high product and service quality, as well as excellent levels of associates training and team motivation, crowned with unique individual touches, make the difference when it comes to attracting leisure travelers.
Although competing in a fast-growing market, the leisure segment remains a fiercely competitive one in the Middle East and North African region, and will continue to be so.
The nominees for Best Four-Star Leisure Hotel:
Coral Beach Resort, Sharjah;
Copthorne Hotel, Dubai;
Beach Hotel, Bai Bin Majid Hotel and Resorts;
Ramada Dira Hotel, Dubai;
Holiday Inn Resort, Half Moon Bay, Al Khobar;
Al Jahra Copthorne Hotel and Resort;
Ramada Plaza, JBR, Dubai;
Millennium Resort, Musana;
Ramada Beach Hotel, Ajman.
And the Best Four-Star Leisure Hotel is sponsored by CHA International. The first silver award goes to the Beach Hotel by Bin Majid Hotels and Resorts. Thank you.
You're late. We're going to need a note. We got to do the selfie. I mean, it is 2014, right? We just need to wait for his arm to grow an extra 12 inches to get everybody in the picture.
Reminding all winners, we encourage you to stay till the end so that we can have a group photograph. The gold winner in this category is the Al Jaffra Copthorne Hotel and Resort.
That's the rowdy table.
Goes to the Millennium Resort, Messana. Now, before we get to our last and long-awaited category, we're going to hand out three certificates of appreciation for service quality to industry colleagues in two essential service areas. For travel technology, we call Res Live Dubai, or reslive.com Dubai, to the stage. We have a certificate of appreciation for reslive.com. And carrying on the certificate of appreciation of service quality is for travel agencies in equal order, and they are Saav Travel and Tourism. Saav Travel and Tourism. Appreciation goes to Kimadar Tours. Kimadar Tours. Thank you.
ladies and gentlemen, it's time for our final category of the evening, Best Five-Star Business Corporate Hotel. The Middle East and North Africa has already established itself as a popular leisure destination, and it's now a growing destination for the corporate traveler as well.
Hotels through the region are rising to meet the challenge with the provision of innovative business solutions and service to meet this vast, demanding segment.
The nominees for Best Five-Star Business Corporate Hotel:
Le Royal Meridian Abu Dhabi,
Al Faisaliyah Hotel, a Rosewood Hotel, Riyadh,
Radisson Royal Hotel, Dubai,
Hilton Beirut Habtour Grand,
Hilton Alexandria Green Plaza,
Intercontinental Jeddah,
Crown Plaza, Sohar,
Millennium Hotel, Doha,
Sofitel, Dubai, Jumeirah Beach,
Dusit Thani Lakeview, Cairo,
Grand Millennium, Dubai,
Grand Millennium Al Wada, Abu Dhabi,
Sofitel Al Khobar, The Corniche,
Millennium Hotel, Amman,
Mövenpick Hotel, Jumeirah Beach,
Conrad, Dubai,
Intercontinental, Abu Dhabi,
The Ritz-Carlton, Doha,
Jeddah Hilton,
W Doha Hotel and Residences.
And to sponsor the Best Five-Star Business Corporate Hotel is CHA International Dr. Sam Saker.
And our silver award of the evening goes to Al Faisaliyah Hotel, a Rosewood Hotel, Riyadh. We have a two-way tie for gold. The first gold award goes to Grand Millennium Dubai. Our second gold goes to Sofitel Dubai, Jumeirah Beach. We'll be right back. And we have a two-way tie for the Platinum Award. The first platinum goes to Le Royal Meridian Abu Dhabi. And our second platinum and final award of the evening, Conrad Dubai. At this time, we'd like to call all of the winners to the stage for the group photograph. All of the winners to the stage, please. Don't leave. Wait. Don't leave. Can we please have all of the winners of the evening please come onto the stage for the group photograph? Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, all of this evening's winners to the stage, please, for the group photograph. All this evening's winners.
And if you're an high school basketball player, you may want to stand at the back.
So, ladies and gentlemen, as we close the MENA Travel Awards 2014, we would like to sincerely thank everyone, including my feet. You have been a fabulous audience, and we'd like to congratulate all of the winners and the nominees of tonight's ceremony. Ladies and gentlemen, we look forward to seeing you at the 11th annual event in 2015. Ladies and gentlemen, congratulations. We'll be right back.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Congratulations to the winners.